ladies and gentlemen, KJ here, and I'm back with another episode of the NWL. And we have an amazing night of action for you tonight. We are kicking it off strong and finishing it strong, as our first match tonight is going to be two heated rivals that are going at it once again. It is Sting versus Chaz Parker, and these two have been rivals since the very, very first episode of the NWL. So to see him go out once again is going to be a treat. It is also, like last week's episode between Sting and Angelini, a possible WrestleMania preview match if Chaz Parker beats Angelini for the championship at Night of Champions. We could see this matchup. So it is a huge match to watch out for tonight. But that is not the biggest one either, ladies and gentlemen, as the biggest one is this main event tonight. The NWL Tag Team Championships are on the line, as Rated RKO's Edge and Randy Orton must defend them against the Chosen Ones, Dolph Ziggler and Drew McIntyre. This has huge implications for Night of Champions. Can Rated RKO hold on to them and go in to defend them? Or will the Chosen Ones upseat the champions, riding a huge wave of momentum? We're going to find out later tonight, but let's get our first match with Sting and Chaz started right now. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, our first match of the night. It is Sting versus Chaz Parker. Two bitter rivals going at it for one more round. Gotta love it when these two always get in the match. It's always an entertaining, always a competitive match. Both of them looking for huge victories. And in the past, Sting has seemed to have always picked up the victory when he needed it most. He's faced Chaz Parker on numerous occasions, and every time he does, he seems to win when it is most important to win. Whenever they face each other at the CPVs, Sting always seems to come out on top. Chaz has very rarely gotten the upper hand on Sting. We'll have to see if that can change tonight, as right now Chaz is looking pretty good here. But so is Sting. Still the early goings of this match. Both guys still feeling each other out. And of course, as I said earlier, this has a huge implications. This could be a possible WrestleMania preview match. Like last week's match with Sting and Vincent Angelini. This one, if Chaz Parker wins the NWL Championship at Night of Champions, he will go to WrestleMania as the champion and face Sting here, who is the winner of the Royal Rumble and gets a guaranteed NWL Championship match at WrestleMania. So, big, big match here. Possible preview we could be seeing. And I gotta say, right now, it is one hell of a preview as a belly-to-belly throw by Chaz Parker and then takes Sting down. He has control of this match right now. He is looking to put Sting away as a huge neckbreaker there. Sting's head game just slammed over the knee of Chaz Parker. And he is showing no remorse, no chance for Sting to get a breather here. He is not letting up. But despite him staying on Sting throughout this whole match, Sting still seems to always find a way to get offense going as he hits a huge suplex right there. Just comes out of nowhere. All of a sudden you think you have him down, but then Stinger just gets back up, re-energized, ready to go some more. Takes a lot to beat this guy down as a beautiful dropkick by Sting levels Chaz Parker. Chaz Parker has a huge motor too as he gets Sting in a submission now. This would be a big, big time win if he can get a submission victory over Sting. Chaz Parker does not know when to call it quits either, especially against Sting, especially for the NWL Championship. It's a big opportunity that he has gotten. Won it the Wednesday after the Royal Rumble in a fatal four-way match, beating the likes of CM Punk, Cowboy Keith, and Shawn Michaels to gain this opportunity. As Chaz Parker now goes outside the ring, takes a little bit of a breather and decides to regroup a little bit. Sting comes running at him but gets hit with a black hole slam. That was not a good decision to come to the outside to go after Chaz. Sting, if he went outside, I mean, possibly was just baiting Chaz into it there. As the ref is up at 6 now, Sting with a huge power slam on Chaz Parker. Ref at 7, Sting gets in. Could be looking for a count-out victory, but Chaz Parker was wise enough to notice the count and get back in. Now Sting going to work on him on the inside. He's started to hold his head here as he's taking quite a bit of abuse in this match. Chaz is probably at the same point here. Both men giving it their all. Both men trying to win this match. Chaz now has Sting up. Hits an F5. Chaz Parker with an F5 to Sting. But Sting wise enough to roll out of the ring. Good job by Sting, because otherwise he could have gotten pinned there by Chaz Parker. Few people get up from an F5. Now Sting will begin the uphill battle of trying to get back into this thing. He's taking a huge amount of punishment right now as Chaz Parker was running to try and get back into ring. Sting catches him and power slams him onto ground. Now he's picking up the steel steps. Ref at 8 and Sting just barely gets back into ring. I don't know what he was doing with those steel steps. Besides potentially getting disqualified with him. And now Sting in trouble. Chaz has him up in a huge pile driver there. And Chaz Parker taunting Sting, taunting the crowd. As crowd is not necessarily behind Chaz in this match, not when the Stinger's involved. Sting with a nice power slam there. And now stomping on Chaz. Every part of him, every limb of Chaz gets attacked by the Stinger, who's now primed and ready. He's waiting for Chaz to get up, and this is not a good place for Chaz. And a Scorpion Death Drop by Stinger. Scorpion Death Drop by Stinger. Here's the pin. Oh, and Chaz Parker kicks out at 2 3/4 there, ladies and gentlemen. I thought for sure Sting had him as soon as 2 hit. I thought it was over. Chaz showing that he's not going away yet. Sting hits a huge clothesline from the corner. Now it's Chaz's turn to try and battle back in this match. Sting, big backbreaker there. And now calling out to the fans. It is showtime here as Sting. Sting gets Chaz where he wants him. Sting gets him in the Scorpion Deathlock. The Scorpion Deathlock by Sting. And Chaz Parker has no choice but to tap out. Sting called for the crowd to get on their feet, get hyped up with it. And he locks in the Scorpion Deathlock. At that point, there is very little that Chaz Parker can do other than tap out and live to fight another day. As Sting is able to beat his rival once again in a big, big match to kick off tonight's action. So we're now going to get ready for our next match of the night. It is the Intercontinental Champion Carnage in action tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And he is going up against the runner-up in that Fatal 4-Way match to determine the number one contender for his championship, Leroy Brown. Leroy wanted to try and get a victory in that match, try and face Carnage. Fortunately, he was eliminated last by the number one contender, Christian Torres. He'll get his chance tonight, though, to face off against Carnage and see if he truly did deserve a match against the Intercontinental Champ. Carnage has been unstoppable, undefeated here in the NWL. You gotta wonder, if Leroy Brown gets the victory, if that may make our general manager, Mick Foley, rethink the decision to put maybe Leroy Brown in this match, too. We're gonna have to find out. It's Carnage and Leroy Brown, next.
Down there, you better just be well, man named Leroy Brown.
So here we go, Leroy Brown facing off against the NWL Intercontinental Champion, Carnage. And Leroy Brown was just one elimination away from facing Carnage at Night of Champions. Christian Torres, though, had a little bit more in the tank, a little bit more incentive to try once again to face Carnage, try once again to capture the title and make a name for himself. However, that could all possibly change, at least making the name for himself by being the first man to defeat Carnage, if Leroy Brown has anything to say about it tonight. He's getting this opportunity to see if he truly should have been facing Carnage for the title. He wants to prove to everyone that he is tough enough to be here to get a championship match like this, possibly in the future. However, he's facing off against Carnage here, the Intercontinental Champion, the undefeated, demented creature that has just bulldozed through everyone put in his path. Guys like Spider-Man that he's taken out, injured, and we haven't seen since. I mean, he's injured the likes of Edge and Dolph Ziggler. He's taken out Christian Torres. He's taken out Boom. He's taken out the NWL Champion, Cowboy Keith at the time, and then the current NWL Champion, Vincent Angelini, both during their reigns as champion. So he has proven that just because he's the Intercontinental Champion, he's possibly the best wrestler on the roster right now. I mean, no one seems to be able to figure him out right now. And I'm just shocked that he only is Intercontinental Champion and doesn't have, you know, the tag team or the NWL Championship around his waist too. Leroy Brown, though, there, was able to catch him, but Carnage outthinking his opponent and then flying off the ropes from the apron, comes flying in off the ropes with a corkscrew crossbody. And see, that's just the thing about Carnage. I mean, I've never seen him do that before. That's the first time I have seen Carnage pull out that move. He seems to pull out a new move almost every week. And every week it seems to be almost as devastating as the week before. And devastating is the term that you use when you face Carnage, because that is what he does to every last opponent of his. So Leroy Brown goes outside to try and think things over, come up with a better plan of action, because it is not working right now. He needs to start using his strengths, needs to start using some quick boxing maneuvers here. Brown is more of a boxer. Oh! And that is a good move by Leroy Brown as he dived out of the way. Carnage came flying out of the ring with a corkscrew, and Brown was able to get out of the way of that. That could possibly turn the tide of this match, as Carnage now is reeling after missing that high impact move. Brown needs to start getting some of those punches in, like I was saying. He's a boxer, real good with his hands and fists, just landing them pretty much precisely where he needs them to be. And just wear Carnage down with, like, the strikes. Just get him in the corner like he is right now and just start laying the strikes in. At his body, at his head. It doesn't matter where you lay it in. If it slows him down, that could be your only chance of winning. Because otherwise, he is fast, he is cunning, he is unstoppable otherwise. And Carnage flips over Leroy Brown. We've seen him do that many times with other people. And now flipping off the ropes, the 450 splash. Brown's starting to hold his head, and you can kind of get a feel right now as he's not getting any offense in at all, that this could be the beginning of the end for Leroy Brown. He had a couple great moments in this match. I don't want to write him off just quite yet, but Carnage has really taken control here, not giving him a chance to breathe, not giving him a chance to get anything going. He needs to find a way to get things going. And now both men are down. Carnage kind of botched that move there a little bit, but he's able to get up to his feet first. picks Leroy Brown up, now has him up on his shoulders, and flings him down. Brown, I think, got Carnage in the eyes there and now starting to use some of those punches that I was talking about. But I think it's a little bit too late. Brown needed to do that from the get-go of this match. So he showed some impressive moves. I mean, he has been very impressive since coming to the NWL here. Nice pile driver there. He had a very impressive Royal Rumble, eliminating two superstars in that match, Leroy Brown did. So now looks for a submission on Carnage, but I don't think he's going to get a submission or a win in this match even, although he knocked Carnage out of the air with there. So he has had some great matches so far here in the NWO, Leroy Brown. So it could be just a matter of time before he does break that glass ceiling and get to the level that Carnage is at. Right now, no one is at Carnage's level. He's stomping on the ground. Kick to the gut, now setting him up. This could be end for Leroy Brown right here, right now, as a pedigree is hidden by Carnage. Now goes to the top rope, and a swanton bomb. Carnage with a pedigree and then a swanton bomb will put away Leroy Brown. Carnage looking dominant, looking unstoppable, looking ready for his match at Night of Champions against Christian Torres. This is a rematch Torres is getting, and if Torres didn't learn his lesson the first time, I hope he learns it this time. I don't think anything different is going to happen. Carnage just looks too dominant. So Carnage continues his dominance here in the NWL, as it seems like no one is able to stop him. I mean, they slow him down temporarily, but he always finds a way to come back and just toys with his opponent till he picks up the victory. Christian Torres better watch out, because Carnage may be unstoppable. Talking about Christian Torres and Carnage, I'd like to remind you guys that Night of Champions is coming up September 28th. Please tune in for that CPV, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be a big night of action. Carnage versus Christian Torres for the Intercontinental title. Chaz Parker versus Vincent Angelini for the NWL title. The tag team titles will be on the line, just like they are tonight in the main event. It is going to be an amazing night of action. You're not going to want to miss it. And we'd like to thank Three Doors Down for their song, Champion in Me. It is the official theme song for Night of Champions. We hope to see you on the 28th. Let's go ahead and get our next match started then. It is a match that features a former NWL champion, Cowboy Keith, versus Wade Barrett. So here we go. Cowboy Keith, former NWL champion, versus Wade Barrett. And Wade Barrett was just in action last week against Shawn Michaels, who had in his corner Cowboy Keith. So this is a little bit of an interesting match. Cowboy Keith requesting, actually, this match, we are being told, to face off against Barrett, just like Shawn Michaels did last week. He was in Michaels' corner, kind of rooting for him, giving him some advice, giving him some distractions along the way, which allowed Shawn Michaels to pick up the victory against Wade Barrett. Huge sweet chin music out of nowhere leveled Barrett and gave Michaels the victory. So now Cowboy Keith looking to do the same thing tonight. Try and beat Wade Barrett in singles action. He, however, does not have Shawn Michaels in his corner. Michaels is actually not here tonight. You gotta wonder if that might make a difference or not. I mean, I really don't think so. Cowboy Keith is a very competent wrestler on his own. You don't become the NWL champion without being that first ever NWL champion, that is. So I think that he's going to be able to easily take care of Wade Barrett here tonight. However, it's still a little bit rude of Shawn Michaels not to be out here for Cowboy Keith, you know. Keith was there for Michaels last week, and now this week he's not here for Cowboy Keith? Man, you don't do that. You know, you support the people who support you. It's what you do. It's Keith doing a good job supporting himself and putting himself in a position to possibly win this match, as Wade Barrett has pretty much been reeling this entire time. Keith has kept the pedal to the metal and hasn't allowed Wade Barrett to get any type of offense until right there. A beautiful reversal by Wade Barrett into a DDT. But once again, that offense is short-lived as Cowboy Keith goes right back on the attack. He's kept Barrett grounded, kept him on his toes, kept him on his back, really. More oftentimes than on his toes. As you can see, on his back once again there. And an elbow right to the gut. Cowboy Keith picking him up and tossing him halfway across the ring, and Keith wants him up on his feet. Could he be looking to put him away right here? Wasteland! Wasteland by Cowboy Keith. Here's the pin. 2. And Wade Barrett kicks out. Wade Barrett, of course, uses the Wasteland himself as a finisher. Cowboy Keith uses it because, you know, being the Cowboy, he is wasted half the time, I guess. At least that's what he has told us, you know. He does enjoy his adult beverages every once in a while, and if he can waste his opponents as much as those beverages waste him, that's all good in his book. And right now, he is wasting Wade Barrett. He is just unable to get any type of offense going. Wade Barrett, though. Wade Barrett now picks up Cowboy Keith and hits a Wasteland. So it's a Wasteland for Keith, now Wasteland for Barrett. But just like before, Keith kicks out at 2.5. Wade Barrett, a little bit of anything you can do, I can do better. We're trading of the Wastelands here in this match. That may have just gotten Cowboy Keith a little bit more ticked off here. You know, Ray was controlling this match. Ray was in a dominant mood. He may be looking to take even more control now. So two of them, facing off outside the ring, and Wade Barrett, I think he may have caught his head on the apron when Keith threw him down. I think he may have caught his head on the ring apron there when he was coming down. And Keith may have noticed that as he slammed his head into the ring post too. and Wade Barrett now on shaky legs. Wade Barrett's on shaky legs trying to turn this match around, but I don't know if he even can turn himself around. Or if he does, it's out of complete confusion and dizziness. Because that is not going to make him feel any better. He's wise enough to roll out of the ring, but not wise enough to stay out of the ring, as Cowboy Keith has him up on his shoulders once again, and once again hits another wasteland. Another wasteland by Cowboy Keith, who is not looking for a pin this time. Goes instead for a submission. It's like a pressure point hold there, right in the shoulder blade region. Wade Barrett now. Huge power bomb by Wade Barrett, and I don't think I've seen him use a power bomb like that before. Barrett with a huge punch right to the side of the head of Keith, who now has Barrett up, has him in a bear hug. Cowboy Keith with a bear hug to Wade Barrett, and Wade Barrett fighting to try and get out of it, but there is no escape, and he taps out. Wade Barrett taps out to a bear hug by Cowboy Keith. And it's not a wasteland that puts him away. Instead, it's a submission, a bear hug, that gives Cowboy Keith the victory. A couple scary moments there as Wade Barrett tried to turn things in his favor. But the Cowboy keeps things rolling as he picks up the big victory once again tonight. And so, ladies and gentlemen, that now brings us to our main event of the night. And it is a huge one. A championship match as the NWL Tag Team Championships are on the line. Rated RKO's Edge and Randy Orton will defend the titles against the Chosen Ones, Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. The Chosen Ones have gained a lot of momentum, beating a lot of people, usually in two-on-one situations, but in a tag team match, they are just as dangerous. They've beaten the likes of Batista, the Devil. They've beaten Edge in a two-on-one match. However, last week, Randy Orton was able to beat them, the first man ever to beat them in a handicap match. Can him and Edge now find a way to beat them once again tonight with their titles on the line? All this hinges now on Night of Champions. The winner will go to that CPV to defend the titles. Is it going to be Rated RKO or is it going to be the Chosen Ones? It's going to be one hell of a ride to find out. So let's go ahead and get it started right now. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, our main event of the night, and it is for the NWL Tag Team Championships, as the champions Rated RKO's Randy Orton and Edge go against the Chosen Ones, Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. Drew McIntyre and Edge starting things off in this match. Two of them going back and forth in the corner before Edge gets out and gets McIntyre in a headlock. This match has come about because the Chosen Ones have been bowling through the tag team competition recently, beating pretty much everyone that has been put in front of them, usually with two-on-one matches. However, tag team matches, they have been just as dominant. They've taken out the likes of The Devil and Batista, and then the two of them in tag team competition have been beaten by the Chosen Ones as well. They then set their focus on the tag team champions after the Royal Rumble, beating Edge in singles competition as Edge gets suplexed into the ring by Drew McIntyre there. McIntyre should be focused on Randy Orton, who is right now the legal man in this match, and not on the man on the outside. It doesn't really seem to be a problem for Drew McIntyre as he takes Orton out and goes after the legs, as we have seen him do many times with his opponents. As I was saying, they beat Edge the Wednesday following the Royal Rumble. However, last week's episode, they actually lost to Randy Orton. It was a 2-on-1 handicap match, and they lost to Orton, the first time that the Chosen Ones have lost a 2-on-1 handicap match, and it was to that man in the ring right now, Randy Orton. However, despite that loss, their impressive stats so far has given the Chosen Ones a tag team opportunity. And so that is why we have this match here tonight. And it has big implications for Night of Champions, of course, ladies and gentlemen. Whoever wins this match goes to Night of Champions as the tag team champions and defends the titles there. Rated RKO has won the titles, beating Legacy at Extreme Rules to get them. Looking to try and keep them going to Night of Champions and defend them once again. Chosen Ones looking to win their first tag team titles. Both of these superstars' first titles, period, in the NWL. Right now it is not an easy task, as Randy Orton seems to have an answer every time McIntyre and Ziggler throw something at him. He's been looking very impressive so far tonight, as he did last week. Seems to have these guys' number right now. Told that move right there, Ziggler with a huge clothesline out of the corner to Randy Orton. And now laying into punches until Orton catches a kick, takes him down, and then gets into a submission hold. But Ziggler able to get out. Dolph Ziggler is challenged for the Intercontinental title multiple times before. Had opportunities to try and win it one or two times, but was unable to even get a championship match. However, he was lucky enough, as well as the man on the other side of the ring, Edge, to get taken out of action by the Intercontinental Champion, Carnage. We mentioned that earlier in the night during Carnage's match. These superstars both have suffered injuries and suffered setbacks due to Carnage. However, here they are in a tag team championship match tonight. And they look very good right now, as Drew McIntyre going after the legs of Randy Orton like he does with so many of his opponents. Orton, as you can see, starting to grab at the knee there. But a DDT by Randy Orton changes the momentum into Rated RKO's favor. And looks like McIntyre actually got busted open from that DDT. As Edge comes into the match off a tag by Randy Orton and gets power slammed by Drew McIntyre. Ooh, and another DDT by Edge this time, and Drew McIntyre is not in good shape as Edge takes him down. Here's the pin. And Dolph Ziggler breaks it up at one. McIntyre holding his head, not looking very good as they've done a great job. Rated RKO has done a great job, that is, isolating McIntyre, keeping him in this match as they tag each other in here, double team on McIntyre. Keep him away from his teammate Ziggler, keep him in the match. That's what you gotta do against the chosen ones. Target one of them and don't let the other man in that ring. They are dangerous. When they can make quick tags and keep each other fresh, they are dangerous. As you can see right there, they were not able to do it, and now Dolph Ziggler will come into the match, which is good news. McIntyre now gets a break, gets a rest, as Ziggler now goes after Randy Orton. The show-off looking to show-off in this match as he hits a nice neck breaker there. Grabs Orton, goes behind and takes out the legs. So we've seen that when McIntyre starts weakening up the legs, Ziggler continues it, and there's an RKO! An RKO out of nowhere by Randy Orton. And Dolph Ziggler's in trouble. Dolph Ziggler's in trouble as he just got hit with an RKO. Rated RKO is looking very good, very impressive in this match. Keeping the chosen ones down, keeping them off balance as Ziggler hits a zigzag. As things are coming very fast here in this match, an RKO by Randy Orton out of nowhere, and then a zigzag by Ziggler out of nowhere. He went for the cover, but the ref must have been distracted. Counted one, but it was at least 2.5. However, he did not start counting right away. That's bad officiating there, as Chosen Ones. The pinning opportunity taken away. Here's another pin. This time the ref's on it, but this time Edge is able to get out almost immediately. Edge now throws Ziggler into the corner, tags in Randy Orton. Holds Ziggler there, and an axe handle off the top rope by Randy Orton. Now gets Ziggler in a submission move. But Ziggler able to easily break out of that one, and then gets himself tossed into the side of the ring. But takes Randy Orton down. Throws Orton into the corner, tags in Drew McIntyre. McIntyre over the top at Ziggler, right to the back. Good double team move by them. Now, ooh, McIntyre, nice face buster there. But Randy Orton got a little bit fired up off of that. Side rushing leg sweep though will put him down on the ground as McIntyre goes back after him. Starts slamming his head into the mat. McIntyre's gotten a little bit of rest, but you can see that he's still holding his head, still bleeding from the head, of course. McIntyre needs to try and find a way to put this match away and put it away fast. A belly-to-belly throw there could help. It's Randy Orton now getting targeted by Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. He's been in the match the most. He's the one they probably want to prove something to the most, of course. He was the first man to beat them in a handicap match last week, so they have something to prove to him this week. There's action is now spilled to the outside here as all four men. Oh, all four men battling on the outside, and Edge picks up McIntyre and slams him down onto the steel steps. He didn't necessarily use the steel steps, so it's not like it's a disqualification, but that could not feel good for McIntyre. As his back went into the steel steps, back of his neck, I mean, God, that had to hurt. Ref, though, now is at 6. 7 as Randy Orton and Drew McIntyre get back into the ring. McIntyre now with a suplex on Randy Orton. Ooh, facebuster there. Drew McIntyre with a facebuster, and now wants Randy Orton to get up. He's looking to try and put this thing away here. Arms hooked and a Future Shock DDT. Future Shock DDT by Drew McIntyre. Here's the pin. Dolph Ziggler came in, knocked Randy Orton. Randy Orton has gotten pinned by Drew McIntyre. The Chosen Ones are the new NWL Tag Team Champions. And a Future Shock DDT by Drew McIntyre. Ziggler came in, knocking Edge off the apron to prevent him from trying to break up the pin. And ladies and gentlemen, we have new Tag Team Champions. Congratulations to the Chosen Ones, who have now become the Champion Ones. And so, ladies and gentlemen, an amazing night of action we had for you. And I'm not just saying that like I always do, but when you have a championship match, ladies and gentlemen, you can't get much better than that. And on top of it, titles changed hands as the Chosen Ones have become the Champion Ones. Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler are your new NWL Tag Team Champions. They hold the belts. They're going to Night of Champions with the belts. You can only think that Edge and Orton will invoke their rematch clause at Night of Champions. Don't know yet. We'll probably find out maybe next week or so. But it was an amazing match. And that's not even counting the rest of the matches tonight, including a huge win by Carnage, continuing his undefeated streak and just racking it up. And then, of course, Sting beating his rival Chaz once again in a possible WrestleMania preview match. You're not going to get much better than that on an episode of the NWL, ladies and gentlemen. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show for tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you tune in next week. If you enjoyed the next episode, please leave a like, as well as any comments you may have down below. Otherwise, I'm KJ, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.